Handwritten lyrics, extravagant costumes and instruments that belong to the singer-songwriter Freddie Mercury are among a personal collection of 1,500 items which are to be sold at auction. The lead singer of the rock group Queen built up the collection, which also includes works of art over three decades and kept it at his home in Kensington in West London. When he died there in 1991, he left the house and its contents to his former girlfriend Mary Austin. She's now decided to sell. In a rare and exclusive interview, she's been talking to our arts correspondent, Rebecca Jones.
Freddie Mercury leading the crowd at Live Aid in 1985. In public, he was the ultimate showman. In private, Freddie Mercury retreated to a home he filled with art and objects that reflected his taste and inspired his imagination. His close friend, Mary Austin, was a frequent visitor.
I don't have that many people to turn to. The only one is Mary. She's been a girlfriend of mine for a long time, and she's about the only person I can think about.
A day after revealing to the world that he had AIDS, the rock star Freddie Mercury has died. As lead singer of the group Queen...
When Freddie Mercury died in 1991, he left that home and its contents to Mary Austin.
The collection takes you deeper within the individual and the man I knew. You see the spectrum of his taste, which is quite eclectic.
She's lived in the house, surrounded by Freddie Mercury's furniture, paintings, instruments and costumes for three decades. But now Mary Austin is selling up.
I've decided to sell because I need to put my affairs in order. And in order to do that, I felt that I needed to sell Freddie's collection in my lifetime.
How did you decide? I mean, I'm assuming there are some things you're keeping. How
no.
did nothing?
No. The only things I'm keeping are the personal gifts that he gave me. I decided that it wouldn't be appropriate for me to keep things back. If I was going to sell, I had to be brave and sell the lot.
So there's the acoustic guitar on which it's thought he wrote and recorded Crazy Little Thing Called Love. There are costumes including his famous fake fur and red velvet crown trimmed with rhinestones and matching cloak, along with artworks by Picasso and Matisse, a marble bar and matching bar stools, and a small, solid silver moustache comb.
Those were the days of our lives.
The sale at Sotheby's is expected to raise £6 million, with some of the proceeds going to charity.
Is there anything, though, that's been particularly difficult to part with?
His written lyrics.
She keeps in a pretty cabinet.
You're looking at the process of the artist, the crossings out, the rethinking, the reformatting. It's just a reflection of Freddie.
There are lyrics written in black biro for Killer Queen.
Caviar, cigarettes, well-versed in etiquette, extraordinarily nice. She's a killer.
Lyrics to We Are the Champions are written across nine pages and include harmonies and chords. Here's Freddie Mercury speaking to the BBC in 1984.
You don't know what it means to when you write a song where people actually appreciate and they say it's a good song. It's a wonderful feeling.
If he'd written something, did he used to play it to you?
No. No, that was his personal private journey. For the amount of time he spent working on Bohemian Rhapsody, I didn't hear any of it until it was a finished, completed work from the studio.
Nothing really matters to me.
Do you miss him?
Oh, yes. Yeah. I miss the fun, the humour. Yeah, his warmth, his energy. Huge.